This weekend I found the mic. Last weekend I was lucky I found the altar. I welcome everyone, all you hearty souls, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today we gather together to celebrate the baptism of the Lord. And if we're honest with ourselves, there are many times we haven't lived out to the gifts of our baptism because we've sinned. So let us call to mind those times and see God's healing for today. I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Grant that your children by adoption, reborn of water and the Holy Spirit,
may always be well pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort, comfort to my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and proclaim to her that the end of her service is at end. Her guilt is expiated. Indeed, she has received from the hand of the Lord double for all her servant sins. A voice cries out, in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight the wastelands, a highway for our God. Every valley shall be filled. Every mountain and hill shall be made low. The rugged land shall be made plain. The rugged country a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed. And all the people shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Go up onto a high mountain, Zion. Prepare the glad tidings. Cry out at the top of your voice. Jerusalem, herald good news. Fear not to cry out. And say to the cities of Judah, here's your God. Here comes with power the Lord God, who rules by his strong arm. Here is his reward with him. His recompense is before him. Like a shepherd, he feeds his flock. His arms, he gathers the lambs, carrying them in his bosom, and leading the ewes with care. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus. Beloved, the grace of God has appeared, saving all, in training us to reject God's ways and worldly desires, and to live temperately, justly, and devoutly in this age, as we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and our Savior Jesus Christ, who gave himself to us to deliver us from lawlessness and to cleanse for himself a people of his own, eager to do what is good. When the kindness and generous love of our God, our Savior, appeared, not because of any righteous deeds we have done, but because of his mercy, he saved us through the bath of rebirth, the renewal of the Holy Spirit, whom he richly poured out on us through Jesus Christ our Savior, so that we might be justified by his grace and become heirs of hope of eternal life. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Christmas, we heard that the shepherds came, and they prostrated themselves before the infant Christ. Last Sunday, we heard the Magi came, and they prostrated themselves before the infant Christ, recognizing his divinity, the all-holiness of God. Today, we hear about John the Baptist, preaching, "Make way straight the way of the Lord," and telling people that they must open their hearts to God's saving work. And many people came from all walks of life. He answered the soldiers, he answered the tax collectors. He even answered those who were good Jews, just trying to make it into a country that was occupied by Rome. We were making all those little, I guess you could say, adjustments to their faith to make it work a little better for them. And John just told each one to repent, to turn from sinful ways, and to walk in the ways of the Lord. And those who found that this message resounded in their own being were coming then to be baptized as a sign of their desire to change their lives, to turn toward God, to turn away from the sin that they had committed. And lo and behold, we hear that this particular day, after all the people had been baptized, even Jesus, something happened. But just imagine the Lord Jesus, whom angels had sung his praises, shepherds had prostrated before him, magi had prostrated before him. Without the blowing of trumpets, without any fanfare, just lines up shoulder to shoulder with all the other sinners, recognizing his mission to take upon himself the sins of the world. Jesus, who was sinless, stood shoulder to shoulder with sinners, identifying with them, taking upon himself the sins of the world. This is the beginning of Jesus' public ministry. This is the beginning of the obvious work that God the Father had given the Son, to be Redeemer of the world. And he came not grasping to equality with God, but emptying himself to take on the form of a slave and emptying himself to identify with sinners. And it wasn't that acceptance that the Holy Spirit hovered over him and the voice of the Father was heard, "You're my beloved Son. With you, I am well pleased. You have come to do the will of the one who sent you, and you are being faithful." And as we reflect on this moment of Christ's baptism, we recall that each of us have been baptized by a baptism much greater than John's, because John's baptism wasn't a sacrament. It was just a representation of what was in people's hearts. But the baptism that we've received is a sacrament. And the Holy Spirit just doesn't flutter over us. He indwells with us. And the challenge for each of us is to let that Spirit of God direct our lives, our thoughts, enlighten our minds, strengthen our wills. This is what the Spirit has been given to us for. To be able to know God's will for us and to have the courage to live that will with a sense of peace, with a sense of joy, and serving the one who has sent us to whom we love. And so tonight, as we gather together, that must have been from last night's sermon. So today, as we gather together, I think it would behoove us to ask the Lord to renew the grace of our baptism in each one of us, to help us become more aware of the Spirit within us, and to nourish that Spirit as we celebrate.
Let us together profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial from the Father, through him are all things made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate and lived on the earth, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken from the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism. And I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and the life of the world to come. Amen. Adopted as children of God by our baptism, we now turn to him in prayer with the response, Lord, hear our prayer.
Let the church be an instrument of the Holy Spirit in faithfully proclaiming the good news. In your goodness,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all peoples will bound together in peace. In your goodness,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are broken and suffering will be renewed by Christ's saving love. In your goodness,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are preparing for baptism, confirmation, will deepen their faith, supported by the community of believers. In your goodness,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That this community, enlightened by Christ and filled with the Spirit, will live out our baptismal calling as disciples of Jesus. In your goodness,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died will be given life promised to them, born again of water and the Spirit. In your goodness,
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace, both foreign and domestic, that God will give those working for peace in speed the day when all emergency and military personnel may return home safely to their families. In your goodness,
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are sick will see the face of God in their suffering, including those listed in our bulletin, and Dolores Arenasio. In your goodness,
Lord,
hear our prayer. For the intentions we hold in our hearts, and especially for Josh Lucas, for whom this Mass is offered. In your goodness,
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious God, Father of us all, we ask you to hear the voices of your children raised in prayer and praise through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please join in singing our offertory hymn, number 512, Christ Be Our Light, number 512.
Thank you. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice into our hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, the offerings we have brought to honor the revealing of your beloved Son, so that the oblation of your faithful may be transformed into the sacrifice of him who willed in his compassion to wash away the sins of the world, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the waters of the Jordan you revealed with signs and wonders a new baptism, so that through the voice that came down from heaven, we might come to believe in your word dwelling among us. And by the Spirit's descending in the likeness of a dove, we might know that Christ, your servant, has been anointed with the oil of gladness and sent to bring the good news to the poor. And so, with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat up, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. As we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and the blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, William, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your honor. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. By the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory of yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who sent your apostles, peace I give you. My peace I give you. Look not on our church, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of the Lord Jesus be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Now let us offer each other a sign of God's peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. nourished with these sacred gifts, we humbly entreat your mercy, O Lord, that faithfully listening to your only begotten Son, we may be your children in name and in truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We have a few announcements. The March for Life in Washington, D.C. is Friday, January 21st. There's a flyer in the bulletin with further details. The next baptism class is this Monday, January the 10th at 7 p.m. in the parish hall. You're asked to please call to register for the class. And you're asked to see the bulletin and the website for more details about all the things happening in the parish. Don't ask me, I don't know. I did get home last week, but you fed me, so I came back this week. And I think I'll be with somewhere in the pastorate for the next 4 to 6 weeks, Father wants me now. So, he's doing well. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless us. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration is ended. Let us go forth to love and to serve God.
Thank you.
Please join in singing our closing hymn, number 383, Songs of Thankfulness and Praise, number 383.